Hi, I'm Rebekka with ESI Audio, and I would like to show you how you can use our recording bundle U22 XT cosMik set to record high-quality vocals on a budget. Let's begin! In this video, I am going to cover three topics. First, I will show you what's in the box of our U22 XT cosMik set and how to set it up. Next, we will talk about our bundle software Bitwig Studio 8-Track for voice recording. And lastly, I will show you some basic examples of voice editing, which can be used to improve your recordings. If you want to skip sections, then just click on the one you are interested in the description at the bottom. Everything you need for a basic setup is in this box. A studio condenser microphone. The ESI set includes the cosMik 10. It comes with a table stand and a foam windshield which can cover the microphone to reduce unwanted breathing sounds. You will also need to be able to hear what you're doing using either studio monitoring speakers or proper headphones. This set contains the extra 10 on-the-ear studio monitoring headphone. You'll also need an audio interface. Included here is U22 XT, a USB 2.0 interface with 24-bit resolution and two ins and outs. And you need recording software. Most ESI interfaces include Bitwig Studio 8-Track, a powerful digital audio workstation, or DAW, with a lot of features. You can work with samples and presets, create loops, play with virtual instruments, and much more. And of course, you can also simply record your vocals, which I will show you in the next section. Even all the cables needed for the setup are included. This is how it looks like unpacked, and now we prepare for our first recording. But please note, before you connect any cables, first install the driver software for your audio interface, and here's how it works. Go to easy-audio.com. Via support at the top of the page, click on download. Then select USB audio interfaces from the top down menu, and after that select U22 XT. The latest version of the Windows driver is always listed first. You just click on it to download the file. If you work with a Mac, you could download special drivers for some ESI products here. However, since U22 XT is class compliant, you don't actually need to download a separate driver. So, Windows users can get the latest version on the top of the list. Download the zip archive and then extract the file. If you are unsure how to do that, check our FAQ page where we explain it. To complete the installation, follow the steps in the manual, and within less than a few minutes, the whole driver installation will be completed. Let's talk more about software. You need a DAW. This is a piece of software that enables you to record your voice and edit it. There are many such applications from different companies, and if you already have one installed on your computer, of course you can use the one you are familiar with. Otherwise, use Bitwig Studio 8-Track, as a license of this is included in the bundle. You can download and install it on your computer and use the serial number from the postcard to register it. Now, let's connect the cables. First, connect your interface with your computer. Now you can connect the microphone. It is important to connect the cable first and only then activate the fan and power switch. When you remove the cable later, you do it in reverse order. First disable fan and power, then unplug the cable. This protects your microphone and ensures you can use it for a long time. Now connect the headphones. And be sure to double check that the input select the switch on the back is set on front by pushing the button in. Now your basic setup is complete. To record, first tell your DAW which device you use for recording so that the proper input will be used. Here is how this is done in Bitwig. Click on the audio track and on the menu that appears on the lower left, go to Input and then select Add Buses. The settings dialog opens in the audio section. Here you select ASIO as driver model. If you are using Windows, as a Mac user, you need to select Core Audio instead. Select U22 XT as device. Under Input Buses, the button Add Mono allows you to add a mono track. Click on the circle under the 1 to define where the signal comes from. By the way, you can also rename the entry mono in, for instance, in microphone. It can be helpful to use such labels, especially if you end up recording different sources and if you want to be able to distinguish them more easily. Now close the dialog and your settings will be saved. Now you can see in the menu in the lower left that you can select the microphone input that you've just created. Click on it and you can instantly see the input signal levels. Now we need to set the input gain. Position your microphone so that the LED points at you and then talk into it with roughly the volume you will use later when you record. Adjust the input gain here to find the proper level. When the peak LED turns red, the gain is too high and your signal will distort and clip. In that case, you need to decrease the gain until the LED remains green. It is a good idea to verify your input level inside the software as well. For the best audio quality, you should aim to keep your input level at around minus 6 dB. The volume of the output signal on your headphones can be controlled with this knob. And now we can start recording. Click on the record button and then click on play to begin recording whatever you like. Your take is completed and you like your recording? Let's move on to editing. Bitwig provides a lot of options for that. For now, we focus on the basics. For testing, I recorded this paragraph of Wuthering Heights.
I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor that I shall be troubled with. This is certainly a beautiful country. In all England, I do not believe that I could have fixed on a situation so completely removed from the stir of society.
You could just hear it without any editing. To start with that, we select our track and click here on the plus and select Audio FX and up here Bitwig. This overview shows a lot of options. We focus on these three basics for now: equalizer, compressor and de-esser. Let's start with the EQ. The EQ changes the volume or the presence of certain frequencies in your mix, like heights, mids or lows. We select EQ5 since the 5-band EQ can fine-tune mids better. Let's choose a basic high-pass filter. With that, you can take out all the very low frequencies, like different types of rumbling noise. Typically, it helps to reduce frequencies under 60 Hz. But keep in mind that every recording is different and you need to be able to work with your material, and here's how you can do that. Go to your take and select a short part of it, which will then be looped. Now play it and you will hear this section again and again, so you can hear all the changes you make in real time.
I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor. I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor. I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor.
To change the volume at a certain frequency, you can click on the circle with the band number and drag it. You could also click and hold on the value and move your mouse up and down. In the mids, we want to make sure it sounds less squeaky, so I move the 3 into this area. And to make the heights appear brighter, we select the shelving filter on band 5. Adjust it so that it sounds better according to your taste.
I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor.
Next is the compressor. In the same way as before, we go through the steps to add more compressor. Here, we keep it simple, since we just select one of the presets. I am selecting vocal compression 2, and you can see down that the values have been adjusted automatically. Then we use makeup to increase the output a bit, making the final signal louder. Now your take sounds more compressed, louder, and overall better.
I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor.
Now we use the de-esser, since even if you use a pop protection screen, it can't prevent some stronger hissing S sounds in your recording. Here we can filter out exactly that. And as before, it helps to play around and find the individual settings that improve your voice recordings. And now we listen to everything again. This is the original.
I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor that I shall be troubled with. This is certainly a beautiful country. In all England, I do not believe that I could have fixed on a situation so completely
And this is the edit.
I have just returned from a visit to my landlord, the solitary neighbor that I shall be troubled with. This is certainly a beautiful country. In all England, I do not believe that I could have fixed on a situation so completely removed.
Finally, you can export your recording as WAV file, and we're done. We are always curious to learn what you are doing with ESI devices. So if you like, add a link to your channel in the comments below this video and show us what you are working on. And in order to get more info about ESI equipment and tips and tricks about recording, subscribe to our channel.